So now that you're aware of a few key components of Illustrator, it's time we begin delving into the tools. We'll begin this section with the very essential Move Tools. When I refer to the Move Tools in Illustrator, I refer to this section of tools located towards the top of the toolbar on the left. We have the Selection Tool, Direct Selection Tool, Lasso Tool, and the Magic Wand Tool. For this video, I will be focusing on the Selection Tool. I like to call it the Black Arrow Tool because it's easier to remember that way. You may want to take a moment to click on this shape tool here, and click and drag a few boxes out if you're following along. The Black Arrow Tool allows you to click on an object to select it, or you can click and drag a box out from anywhere on screen that is not occupied by another object. Anything caught in this box will be selected. Another way you can select multiple objects is by holding the Shift key and manually clicking on several objects at a time. You can tell an object in Illustrator is selected when this thing called a bounding box surrounds it. The Black Arrow Tool is an all-essential tool, not just because it can select objects, but because it can move them and resize them as well. You can move them around by clicking directly on the object, holding it, then dragging your mouse around. For objects that are just an outline, you'll need to click on the outline, not the space inside of it. Alternatively, to more precisely move objects, you can nudge them around using the arrow keys on your keyboard. To resize a selected object, you'll need to pull the sides and corners of the bounding box when your cursor changes to these type of arrows. Furthermore, by holding Shift while moving an object, you can lock it into 8 different directions, rather than just moving it freely. Similarly, by holding Shift while resizing an object, you can lock its proportions in place and resize it while maintaining its original shape. You can also hold Shift while nudging objects with arrow keys to move them at greater lengths. Hey, real quick, just something I forgot to mention in my original recording. The Black Arrow Tool is also capable of rotating objects as well, just by grabbing onto the corners until your handle turns into this shape. It's also capable of rotating on specific angles if you hold Shift. So for example, if I start at the default state that it's in, I can rotate 45 degrees every time. That's all. Another feature of the Black Arrow Tool is its ability to round or sharpen edges of shapes. For the Black Arrow Tool, this feature is mostly relegated to objects created with the Rectangle, Rounded Rectangle, and Polygon Tool. By dragging these circles located on the corners of these objects, you can make them rounder or sharper as you please. These circles will not show up for the Black Arrow Tool if the selected object deviates too much from the shapes I already listed. Finally, you can access the Black Arrow Tool by clicking where it is in the toolbar, or you can do yourself a favor and learn the shortcut for accessing it. You can change to this tool by hitting V on your keyboard, or you can temporarily change to this tool by holding Control on Windows and Command on Macs. We're one tool in, and we've already been exposed to quite a lot of information. I know it might seem like a lot, but hang in there. It really is a lot simpler than it sounds. We can really just boil down the Black Arrow Tool's function to, it lets you move a whole object. Keep what else it can do in mind though, as this tool is one of the backbones of Illustrator.